Hey everybody, I'm Nathaniel Dodds from tutvid.com. Welcome right into this Adobe After Effects tutorial where today we're going to talk about masking in After Effects. There are actually a bunch of different ways to mask, but the best way to mask is the way that you know how to mask. So we're going to cover some of the basics of getting your feet wet and dabbling in some masking in After Effects. If you enjoy this video, make sure you subscribe to the channel so you never miss any videos in the future. Let's jump into After Effects and get this thing started. Okay, here we are in Adobe After Effects. Let's just jump in and touch on a couple things that have to do with masks. Number one, if you have a layer selected, like I've got this video layer selected, a little creepy, right? If you have something like this selected and you grab a shape tool and you start drawing with the shape tool, pen tool, whatever it may be, you are going to create a mask. You can see the mask is now, we see the video through this circle as though somebody has laid a sheet of paper over the video and we've just cut a perfect circle in the middle. I'm going to hit Command or Control Z to undo that. When you're drawing out a mask with something like the ellipse or the square shape, hold down Shift and you'll get a perfect square or circle or whatever it is you're looking at. Once you have your mask, you can grab the selection tool and you can double click on the mask and it's going to bring up these transform handles. Again, you can hold down Shift and you can resize your mask. You can actually drag the mask and move it around a little bit if you like. And of course, you can do stuff like crunch it down, rotate it. You can do all, you know, bring it down, make it more of an oval, something like that if you like. I'm going to go ahead and make this a little bit bigger. Whoop, I don't want to drag it up. I want to make it a little bit bigger. Something, I actually want to put it kind of in the middle of my document like that. Now, let's say you wanted the nurse to be looking directly through this oval and not offset. Well, this is where the pan behind tool becomes useful. You can select that and then you drag the video that is within your mask. Well, let's just grab our selection tool and double click this mask once more, then grab the pan behind tool. And then we can just grab that video and we can go ahead and drag it sort of underneath the mask just like that. One other thing that's kind of cool about the mask is you can see, I'm going to grab my selection tool again. Down here in our nurse video layer, we have this mask sort of sub layer within that layer. It's more or less just something that's attached to the layer. And there is our first mask, mask number one. Now there's a mode attached to it. And right now it's at add. If I set it to subtract, what it's going to do is it's going to leave the rest of my video and just use that mask shape and punch a hole through the video. I'm going to go back to add. You can also tick on inverted and it'll just swap you between sort of showing the area you want to mask or using that shape as something that's punching a hole through your video or graphical layer. I'm going to double click my mask. You want to double click it and we can hit our delete key and just delete it. And then with the video selected, we can just go layer, transform, and just reset this. And it's going to resize it to the way it was when I first imported it. We'll go transform here and we'll just choose to fit it to the comp, which will just blow it back up the way it was. I am, with this video still selected, we're going to create another mask. I'm going to stick with the ellipse tool. All the other tools kind of work the same. And I'm going to hold down shift and I'm going to drag out a rather large mask like this. I'm going to double click on it. Well, I need to get my selection tool here. And then I'm going to double click on it and I'm going to drag it to kind of right about there. I'm going to grab my ellipse tool again and I need to double click this mask to kind of deselect it, if you will. And I'm going to drag out another smaller mask here in the middle. I'm holding down my spacebar key, and that allows me to move the mask around before I kind of let go with my mouse and commit the change, right? But you can see that mask doesn't look like it's doing anything. But we have drawn a second mask. The reason that it's not doing anything is because the mode is still set to add. Let's try setting this to subtract. And you can see when we do that, it's kind of in a little bit of conflict with the mask above it. So the mask above is adding, but this mask is subtracting, therefore punching a hole in the video. So by combining mask shapes, you can create these complex masks where we have this donut shape now, which is our mask. All right, I am going to select both of these mask shapes here. I'm going to delete them both because what I want to do is show you now with this video selected the pen tool. So let's say with the pen tool, I'm going to zoom out just a little bit here. I'm going to go maybe to 50%. Let's say I want to just create a rough mask along the edge of her because we want to, I don't know, put something else back there. What I'll do is I can draw with the pen tool right down along here. And I can grab my tangent handles here. If I hold down Alt or Option, I can just move one tangent handle at a time. And I'm just going to very roughly draw in a mask just like that. And then I'm going to loop around to select this whole side of things. Now you can see that because I've selected that whole side of things, it's actually saving that and making her disappear. I obviously don't want that. I want to change the mask mode to subtract, so we're subtracting that away. But you can see that we're still getting this really harsh edge. It looks really bad. We want this to, you know, look a little bit more natural. So I'm going to open the mask up here, and we have some options. We have our mask path, of course, but we also have mask feather and mask opacity. Let me just quick show you here. Mask opacity, and I'm going to set this back to fill or fit. And mask opacity, that's going to basically allow us to see through. You can see how it's sort of saying, yeah, we can allow her to be semi-opaque, select this area of background, but then invert the whole thing. But aside from mask opacity, we have mask expansion here, which obviously is just going to expand or contract our mask in either direction if we need to make a little kind of micro adjustment. But most importantly here, I want to show you the mask feather. This is blurring the edge of the mask. So we can blur the edge because, you know, the edge of her is pretty blurry. And this probably we would say, you know what, expand the mask a little bit, kind of like that. And we very quickly and easily can create a what would appear to be a really complex mask along the edge of this video. Then, of course, you can go in and you'd have to animate those keyframes. But creating the initial mask is what we're all about right here, right now. And maybe I'd be remiss if I didn't show you how to animate it a little bit. So what we would do is we would be animating our mask path. So I'm going to just begin right here where the mask looks good, and I'm going to drop a keyframe by hitting the little stopwatch icon. It's going to drop a keyframe, and maybe I'll move backward. And what we can do is we can select individual points on our mask, and I can say, yeah, pull that part of the mask up there, this part of the mask down here, this part of the mask here, and this one right over here. Great, and then we'll move back a little further, and we would pull this down. This essentially is what you would call rotoscoping, where you're just kind of dragging and animating along with, dragging a mask and animating a mask along with your keyframes. And as it's looking, it is a bit of a manual process here, but the final results can often be really, really nice. And I can bump this over a little bit more. I'll probably speed the video up here just so you don't have to sit and painstakingly watch me go over every single little keyframe here. And I'll be back in just a minute. And there we go. I've animated about 2 seconds of the mask. And if I deselect, you can just see that whole background next to her just looks white the whole time. And if we select the layer with the mask, what you can do is you can see the mask actively just kind of dragging along and following the edge of the, not really the edge of the video, but the edge of her face just like that. So masks are just super versatile. It's 100% something you should be looking at. One of the first things you should really be trying to get good at is masking, rotoscoping stuff. They're just very rudimentary, fundamental skills that the more you get used to working with that stuff and learn how to do it, just the easier everything else will become for you as you continue your journey through After Effects. So there you have it. Just a quick primer to get your feet wet in when it comes to masking in Adobe After Effects. There's so much that you can do when it comes to masking in After Effects and animating masks and so on and so forth. This is really just something to get your feet wet and get you interested and take away some of that fear of masking. If you enjoyed the video again, may I remind you, subscribe to the channel so you never miss any video tutorials or just videos in general on the channel in the future. If you do Instagram, you can follow me on Instagram at tutvid. That would be super cool. If you're more of a Discord type person, discord.me/tutvid is our server over on Discord where the conversation is continued day and night without fail. For learning how to build a mask and mess around with some of the properties that have to do with creating a mask and resizing a mask and just generally getting started with masks in Adobe Illustrator. Did I say Adobe Illustrator? I meant Adobe After Effects. For me, that's it. Get it? Got it? Good. Nathaniel Dodson, tutvid.com. I'll catch you in the next one. And before you go, make sure you subscribe to my channel for more great tutorials every day. Also, buy my course. It helps us do what we do, and this channel is supported by viewers just like you. You can also just click the thumbnail and watch another video from this channel. See you next time, guys.